There's never been a situation that he didn't have an answer to. Amen. Yep, he's never been afraid. My mother, I won't buy her to testify, and then we're going to, I promise you, we'll fix and do one and let you go. My mother was my very first Sunday school teacher, my very first children's church teacher, and she used to teach by flannel graph. Y'all remember the flannel graphs? When you put the little pictures on that felt and peel them back off?
Uh-huh.
I was amazed by those things. And, I can remember so vividly her telling the story of when Jesus was on board the ship and they were going to the other side for rest. He had been ministering and he just said, let's go to the other side. The Bible records a story that they were out on the rough seas, that they were about to capsize. And I remember Mama taking that boat and she'd take it and they'd do this. There was waves up there and she'd have them dive down in and stuff. They had this one where a lightning bolt, and she talked about how the lightning would flash and crash. And the thunder would roll. She said the vessel was just about to go under. And yet Jesus was in the hind part of the ship, asleep. Asleep. Listen, one of the disciples who had been with God, had been with Jesus, and had seen him feed the multitude. They had seen him heal the blinded eyes. They had been with him when he raised the dead. They were with him when the woman crawling through the streets said, if I can just get to him, touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. They had seen these things happen. And yet one of the disciples is on board this ship and goes running back to Jesus and says, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Hold on. Let me make that South Alabama for you. Do you not care we fish to die out here? Hey Jesus, in case you ain't noticed, ain't nobody rocking you to sleep. We about to die.
Come on.
That's South Alabama.
Yep.
If we going down, this is it. Got a hole in the boat going down.
Come on.
And he says, and he walks up and he says, peace. And he goes back to sleep. You just missed the best message that I've preached all day long. Listen, hold on. The storm never woke up the master. No matter how loud the lightning made its boom, he never was alerted. No matter how bad the waves beat the vessel, he wasn't alarmed by the storm. It wasn't until the cry of one of his own children did the master rise to the attention. There's somebody here. Christian always waiting for somebody to call on. The storms that are in life, that don't get his attention. My grandfather used to say this. We grew up in Mobile. We had those afternoon storms and squalls that come off the bay. And just out of nowhere, that thing would go boom. We would begin to run back to the house, trying to jump up in Papa's arms. As long as we made it in the house, and Papa would always say this, he'd say, Buck, Are you scared?
Yeah, I'm scared.
He'd say this. But you see, but above the storm clouds, the sun is still shining. He's not alarmed by the storm. I'm trying to help somebody in here. The storm that you're going through right now is not what gets the master's attention. He's bigger than any storm. He's louder than any lightning bolt. He's not intimidated by the things the devil will try to throw at you. But would you call on him tonight? Byron, I want you to sing this song. Somebody, go get God.
Thank you, Lord.
God is thankful to hear his children. Victories will come our way.
Yes.
We will seek him while we can find him. His hand today. Somebody go get God. Somebody go get God. Tell him we're thirsty.
Today, God, it's been worth the trip. I thank you, God, for allowing us to be a part of it. But Father, even tonight, there may be one that's here that's out of the ark of safety. And as I have planned with you, I ask God that you walk up and down the aisles of this church and between the pews and convict every single heart and woo them in Lord, what I do know is that I'm not perfect. I have messed up so many times. I've been weak times, God, when I know that you were disappointed in me. But God, your loving, compassionate grace always reached down in your mercy. Reach down to me in the darkest of times. And Lord, you don't love me any bit more than you love anybody else here. I ask you, Heavenly Father, that you would reach down to every single person's heart that's here. Convict hearts. Woo them in. Father, what I do know is that anything that we're going to do for your kingdom, we've got to be doing it now. For time is short. And it is sure. Time is short. In Jesus' name. If you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior, would you please allow me to introduce you to the greatest friend I have ever had, who has stood by me when I didn't deserve it. To report it to you this morning. Aren't you glad that God never gave you what you deserved? I'm glad God didn't give me what I deserved. But his grace and his mercy reached down, pulled me up, and saved me, delivered me, set me free. And he will do the same thing for you.
You are the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, and now. Bless your heart, Miss Martha. Love you all.
Yeah.
This is the end. I believe. Say that with me. This is the end. Inhale. Say. This is the end. I believe. Do you love it?
Yeah.
Have you enjoyed being with Compass today? We want you to do something for us. I want you to go by our table and take a card with you and put it on your refrigerator. But every time you go by your refrigerator, we want you to ask God to anoint us more today than we were yesterday. We go all over the show. We're going to be going to Arkansas. We go back to Georgia, but twice, South Alabama, two or three times, Mississippi, two or three times. And we need the anointing of God everywhere that we go. And we ask for your prayers. We also have a card back there that should God deal with your heart, that you would like to come and covenant with us. We would welcome your support. But now, if it takes away from your local church, we're not interested. We'll not do that. But if God should birth them, burden your heart for us, would you just do that? Would you just commit to praying for us and praying that God would have you support us on a regular basis? I thank you so very much. One more ribbon to cross. One more ribbon to cross.
One more minute, one more time.
serve the devil noticed. Hallelujah. I didn't testify just a minute ago. Glory to God.
Come on.
I've got a daughter. I give him all the glory.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. About 2 years ago, my faith was kind of like this. But I knew God was on the throne, and I knew he had everything in control.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
We prayed and we continued to pray.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
You are healing in Jesus' name.
I give God all the glory. I just want to serve the devil notice. He's a defeated fool. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My children are going forth. In the name of Jesus. Amen. He can go back to hell where he came from. Amen. I give God all the glory. She was baptized tonight.
Yeah.
And I give him thanks and give him glory for answered prayer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you're doing good to the purpose today. Go to Facebook. You got Facebook? Go to purpose.al. Purpose.al, like our page, keep up with us, find out where we're going to be in the area. If we are in the area and you're not having church, come be with us. If you are having church at church, you be faithful to your church. Your church needs your support.
Yes,
needs you to be faithful. But if you're not having church, come be with us sometime. God bless you. We love you so much, Pastor. Thank you so much. God bless you.
There's somebody here. You think you're standing at Mount Everest. But you know what? You're not. You know, back in February, me and Johnny was going through something. I'm going to tell you, God done something for us that normally takes over 2 years to get done. It happened for us in 9 months. You know, God seen fit. I got my disability, and it only took me 9 months to get it. At Mount Everest, I thought I was not going to get through it. You know, there was a time that we didn't even know what we was going to feed my daughter. I was fixing to call Sandra and tell her to keep her because she had just spent the night with her, because I didn't know. There was nothing in the house that she would eat. But right before I picked up the phone to call Sandra, a godly friend of mine called me. And she said, God said you need something. I said, I need your prayer. I said, we need your prayer bad. And she said, no, God said you need something. And she said, God said you need groceries. And she said, you better tell me what you need or I'm going to the grocery store and I probably won't get nothing that you need. You know, and I told her, I said, if you'll just bring milk, sugar, and eggs. Tomorrow I eat eggs. And I thought, if you'll just bring that, we'll get through it. Well, she showed up with groceries.
Praise the Lord.
The next day, somebody else showed up with money.
Praise the Lord.
That's how God is.
Yes.
You know, somebody here, you're standing, and you think you're not going to get through it.
Hallelujah.
Get the mics.
There's God.
It all found God.
Stood at the foot of what felt like
salvation. One thing is sure every time. Over and over, again and again, God is faithful. Over and over, again and again, through it all, He's made me Jesus is with me, so I'll claim the victory over and over again. You ask me why, I have no hesitation. God does what He says He will do. I simply say every battle. There's nothing He won't help me through. So why should I dwell on the hardships and struggles when I look just beyond them and see the way this will end is a great celebration. And deep in my heart I believe. Over and over, again and again, God is faithful.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I want to say this. Truly, we appreciate purpose, all that God's done through them tonight. We give God the glory. Amen. Thank Him for coming this way. Amen. Appreciate you for coming this way. We do have food in the fellowship hall. Amen. If you'd like to come and eat with us, you feel free to do so. Amen. There's plenty of food left over from today. Amen. And it was put up right, so it's still good to eat. Amen. So if you'd like to eat with us, you come on. Amen. But I want to tell you, somebody, you need to quit running from God and run to God. Amen. You need to quit. You need to hear what God's saying to you, because you're not promised to tomorrow. Amen. And God don't play. Amen. Come here, Brother Johnny. Hallelujah.
I don't know who this is for, and I don't know why God wants me to tell it, but he knows everything. A man was going home from a conference. He went across the bridge. It was pouring down rain. Trailer truck lost control, got over to his lane, hit the man in the little car head on. Truck ran plumb over the car. I mean, the tractor trailer, the whole truck, and the trailer all, and squished that car just as flat as it could possibly be. They went, the fire department and the paramedics, they went and checked the man. It only could reach the arm inside because the car was in such bad shape. Somebody needs to hear me tonight. I'm telling you, the Holy Ghost wants somebody to know something here tonight. It's not too late with God. It's never too late with God. But you know, if they would reach inside there, Brother Derek, and they couldn't feel a pulse, none of the paramedics, none of the firemen could feel a pulse. So the car was in damage so bad, and the man was tore up so bad, and just covered the car up with a piece of plastic, and just looked on to get ready to haul it off with the record. And it was just waiting on the guy that the guy, the coroner, to get there to pronounce the man, because it was a law in that state. The coroner had to come and pronounce him dead, that he would have been dead for an hour and a half. A man came by and said, asked the state trooper, said, "Do you mind if I pray for these folks?" He said, "Why don't you go over at that car on the right-hand side and pray for them?" He said, "They're injured pretty bad, but they're still alive." He said, "Well, what about the man down yonder in the car that's covered up with the plastic?" He said, "It's too late for him." He said, "No, it's not too late for him." He said, "You can pray for those." He said, "That's not the one I pray for. I want to pray for. The Lord told me to pray for that man in the car with the covered up plastic." Hallelujah, somebody. Hear what the Holy Ghost has to say tonight. My mouth's so dry, I can't hardly talk, but that's just the devil wanting me to stop. But in the name of Jesus, I will say what he'd have me to say. Been sitting back too long. Done pleased the devil too many times, Sister Rita. But you know, it made the trooper told him, said, "Didn't you understand what I said? It's too late for him. He's been dead for an hour and a half." He said, "The Lord told me to go pray for that man." He said, "Well, how about it? You won't see nothing but skin and bones and a mangled up person all over the place." He said, "But go ahead and have at it." The man went to him. They had to cut the car all to pieces. The man went to him and could only stick his hand in so far to reach the guy. He was so mangled up. And he began to pray for him in the name of Jesus. He began to pray for him. About halfway through the prayer, he began to sing a song. After about a second verse, that man began to sing the song with him. For an hour and a half, he was dead on that bridge. And God brought that man back to life. You know why they let God left Lazarus in the grave for 4 days? They thought after 3 days the man was dead in the Old Testament. But you know what? Jesus waited intentionally for the 4th day so that they would know who he was, that he was the resurrection. He is the truth. He is the life. And he is the way. And somebody here tonight needs to listen to what God is saying. Just because it looks bad, just because it feels bad, just because it seems bad, just because it is bad, don't mean it's bad. If we'll just give God a chance, he will prove himself.
God just wants you to give him a chance. Amen. Hallelujah. I can tell you tonight, amen, that he's no respecter of a person, amen. 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 Hallelujah.
I didn't come. Yeah, I didn't come.
He's no respecter of a person, amen. You're lost and undone without Jesus, amen. You're taking a chance to making hell your home, amen, by not surrendering and crying out to him.